All right, welcome to another episode of Restoration Renegades. I'm your host, Jeremy West, along with two experts from Dalworth Restoration, Mr. Nick and Josh Hobbs, and of course, the original do-it-yourselfer cowboy of restoration. That's right, Mr. Jason Ward. Hey guys, how are y'all doing?
Good.
Awesome. Good. Doing fantastic. Awesome. In fact, I've got a very important question to ask, and this is what a lot of people that may have, they're renting from some place, perhaps it's commercial or even an apartment complex. And that question is, in the event of water damage, what would renter's insurance cover?
You know, Jeremy, that's a great question. That's one we get asked often, and I think it's really important to note that you know, when you have a renter's insurance policy, normally what happens is when you have a flood from water, source, whether it be a toilet, or a hot water heater, or a washer, washing machine, dishwasher, normally what you're going to have coverage on is your stuff. You know, when I say stuff, I mean your contents. And so normally what happens is all of the structure is going to be, something that the landlord, homeowners, it's going to be covered in the homeowner's landlord policy. And all of the contents and all the stuff that you brought into that space is going to be covered under your renter's insurance. And so it's really important to understand lease agreements too, because a lot of the language as to those rules and what's covered, what's not, is going to be in that lease agreement. And it's different for commercial as it is residential. In commercial, you could see more commonly where someone that's come into a space and has remodeled it is going to be responsible for that structure and the contents. But usually on the residential side, your renter's insurance is just going to be, your stuff.
Gotcha. So it's important to have renter's insurance, because some people you don't naturally just have renter's insurance. Yeah, that's something you have to go get.
Yeah, that's something that you a lot of times would see people getting stuck in a loss or something like this happens and their stuff's damaged and they don't have insurance, and they certainly at that point wish they would have had it at that time. So,
well, I would wonder, is there a difference between personal liability or something incidental, like if my kids throw TP in the sink, turn the water on, it floods the whole place, versus a water line that breaks? Is there a difference there?
Usually there's not. The landlord or owner of the building or house is generally responsible for the dwelling itself. The coverage is still on the homeowner in terms of the structure and getting drywall dried out, any repair work that needs to take place. Now, one thing that we do see is that there's sometimes contingencies in those lease agreements saying that if something like that was to happen, that the tenant is responsible. And so those are sometimes it can be hidden language, because those aren't necessarily things that are being pointed out unless you read it. And so we've had those things come up in the past where the tenant is responsible for the water damage, or at least covering maybe the deductible portion of the claim for the landlord. And so that's a great question.
Good to know.
Okay, so that's a very good case for understanding your renter's insurance policy as well as your lease agreement. And in the unfortunate case of water damage, simply go to restorationrenegades.com, where you can find an expert near you who can help you. Now, please be sure to subscribe to our channel as well as smash the bell so that you get all of our next episodes. And we will see you on the next episode.